Americans wanting to experience true London, this is it. You're right between Knightsbridge and Kensington, you've got Kensington Palace there, it's just London in a nutshell. And the hotel, of course, is just historic London style as well. I've always stayed in the flat hotel and I enjoyed it. Of course, you always feel welcome when you come back to a place where people know you. It's an independent hotel, so it's not a big corporate chain, obviously, and there is a much more personal feel to it. Anthony Bourdain's restaurant, Brasserie La Salle, which is on Park Avenue South. I think he's a great character and it's a wonderful restaurant. Great French cuisine and a great American set. Other than that, I very much like the Grand Central Terminal. Some of the restaurants in there, there's Cipriani Dolce up on the balcony, which is nice. Great atmosphere because you're in the middle of the terminal. If it's a nice day in the summer, I like to go and just sit in Central Park, to be honest, walk around the lakes. Rockefeller Center is always great in the winter, you know, the skating. Rockefeller Center is a beautiful complex.
Yeah.
And use the air train. I mean, for the first many times when I went over, I was taxiing it everywhere. Which is, of course, cheap compared to London. But especially if you're going midtown, downtown in New York, not worth it. You know, you get on the subway and you just, because you have these services. New Yorkers I find very helpful. I do find New York subway a little complicated initially, because here our lines have different colours. In New York, you have one line and then you have all these little letters and numbers written next to it, so it's a little difficult to figure out which one is going where, because then they all divide out, I suppose. But it's very helpful. Every time I've been to New York and used the subway, you ask somebody and, you know, within 10 seconds you have a whole little crowd of people discussing what's the best way for you to go.